In this video, we'll uncover whether or not carbs are bad for you. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Zarowski, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification and join our notification community so I can help you excel your health and your life. In this video, we're talking about, are carbs bad for you? And then we also want to discuss how many carbs should you be eating on a regular basis? And so, you know, this is a really convoluted topic because there's people who are on the ketogenic diet that say you should have no carbs at all. And then there's people who are on the complete opposite end of that spectrum, saying you should eat a lot of carbs. And then there's even studies out there that kind of show you, you know, the difference between those two. So there's studies saying that if you eat low carbs, you're going to have an early chance of death. And there's studies saying that you're going to decrease your risk of stroke and early death if you actually have a low carb diet. So anyway, let's go ahead and try to clear up some of that confusion. So in this video, we're going to talk about a couple studies out there and what we need to know about them, especially the ones that really go and demonize a low carb diet. And then we're also going to look at the benefits of a low carb diet. And then from there, we'll discuss good carbs versus bad carbs, and also how many carbs you should eat a day. And at the end of this video, what I'll do is I'll share with you where you can find a link to my list of good carbohydrates that you can eat on a daily basis. So let's go ahead and jump in. Now, when we look at this first study here that I'm going to talk about, it's important to know that it was done in Lancet, which is a very prestigious medical journal. And so what they were doing in this study is they were looking at these people and saying, well, are carbohydrates good for you or are they bad for you? And so what happened is the study came out and then all these different news outlets reported on it. And when they reported on it, they just were looking to get a lot of clicks. They're looking to get a lot of views. And so, you know, they didn't really dive into the study and give you the truth behind it. They kind of just, you know, at a glance, gave you their initial thoughts. And many of their initial thoughts were, first of all, eating a low carb diet is going to cause early death. And then the other thing was that if you are consuming this low carb diet, that you're going to be unhealthy and that you should consume a high carb diet. And some of these different news outlets were even saying that you should be consuming a diet that is 50% carbohydrates or more. And so here's the deal. Let's go ahead and talk about this first study. So, you know, like I said, basically the study said low carb diet equals early death. And so there's a couple problems with this study that said that a low carb diet is going to cause you to have early death. Basically, when they referred to low carb, they were referring to anything that was 40% and below. Most people would not consider that to be a low carb diet. You know, what is a low carb diet at that point, right? And then the next thing, there's a lot of confounding variables. And what that means is there was variables that they didn't control within the study, because the study even points out that, you know, many of the people who are consuming a low carb diet were the unhealthy people. They're the people who were smoking. They weren't exercising. They were, you know, sitting around a lot, not moving. They were just living very unhealthy lifestyle. They may have already had a condition that they had developed prior to this whole thing and that they were already facing. And so anyway, there's a lot of variables, and we know that that's important because nobody ever had said that following the ketogenic diet or a low carb diet, but yet smoking and doing a whole bunch of things that is really bad for you is going to offer you good health. So, you know, we have to be aware of that. And then last thing I want to mention about this study that, you know, led to it being pretty flawed is that it was all based on recall and questionnaires, meaning that when they were going back and finding the information out as to what these people were eating and, you know, how many carbs and all that, they're basically just doing it off of recall. So how many carbohydrates did you eat a month ago for dinner? And then the other thing was, is that there was questionnaires. And so a lot of people tend to put their best foot forward, right? I mean, we see this in many of the YouTube videos we watch, or maybe some of the different you know, articles we read or people we follow online. Everybody's putting their best foot forward. And so, you know, there's no reason to believe that people wouldn't do that as well. If they know that the diet is looking for them to eat low carbohydrate, they're going to say, well, yeah, I probably didn't eat as many as you know, maybe I initially thought I did. And so anyway, you know, we have to take that into consideration as well. So recall and questionnaire is basically going to cause a little bit of a problem there. And so there's a lot of flaws in this study. And so we have to take that whole thing into consideration. Now, Lancet did another study. And what I'll do, by the way, is link both of these studies below so you can dive into them yourself. But this study was called the PEER study. I'm just referring it as study number two. And basically what they did is they had the complete opposite findings. And in this study, they found that if you have a high carb diet, you're going to have an increase in mortality. And they also found that a high fat diet in this study will decrease your risk of mortality and decrease your risk of stroke. And so Anyway, this is very confusing to the average person who's going and reading these. And, you know, what we want to do is make sure that we interpret them correctly and understand that there was a lot of flaws in this one that was saying that a low carb diet is going to cause an early death. So we have to take that into consideration. So let's go ahead and talk about the benefits of a low carb diet. You know, as you know, like I said, in your heart of hearts, you know that eating, you know, high carb diet, high sugar diet, low quality foods is going to destroy your health. So let's go ahead and talk about some of the benefits of low carb diet. So first of all, you're going to have a decreased chance of getting type 2 diabetes. So as we eat a lot of carbohydrates, a lot of refined carbohydrates, you're going to spike that insulin, you're going to spike that blood sugar, and you're going to eventually get diabetes that comes along with it. So low carb diet is going to help you decrease your risk of that. We also are going to improve our cognitive function with a low carb diet and also improve neurological health. Okay, so you know, people who are on low carb diet, high fat diet, they're able to have a lot more energy to, you know, just have good thought processes and be able to focus. And then people who have a low carb diet also have better neurological health. You know, it's just like diabetes. Typically, the same people who have diabetes have Alzheimer's and neurological degenerative disorders. And so when we have a low-carb diet, we're keeping that insulin low, keeping that blood sugar low. Essentially, it's going to improve neurological function and well-being. Now, the next here is hormone balance, okay? So the more carbs that we eat, we're going to have more insulin spikes. And so we want to make sure that, you know, from a hormone balance perspective, that we're not consuming a super high-carb diet. It's going to improve our digestion. It's going to give you less cravings, because the more sugar you eat, the more cravings you have, just simply because sugar acts like a drug on the brain. Basically, it's going to, you know, boost up that neurotransmitter dopamine. It's going to activate that brain reward cascade. And as a result, the more sugar you have, the more sugar that you crave. And so decreasing the amount of sugar you're consuming is going to be really powerful. The next thing here is you're going to have more energy. We've talked about this many times in other videos that, you know, having high fat diet, low carb diet, is going to give you more energy, because fat is a more sustainable energy source. People who are using sugar as an energy source have a lot of highs and lows, and so that's not good. And the last thing here is going to be a decrease in metabolic syndrome. So things such as heart disease, things such as high blood pressure, insulin resistance, you're going to have a much lower risk of that if you're following a low carb diet. Now let's go ahead and talk about these good carbs versus bad carbs. Now just like anything, there's going to be good quality and bad quality foods. And so even when it comes to carbohydrates, we need to make sure that we're differentiating between good and bad carbs. You know, there's so many diets out there that just give you the number of carbs that you should eat, but they don't tell you to make sure that you're eating high quality carbs. And so this is really important, because there's a huge difference. When we look at good carbohydrates, they're nutrient dense. They have benefit to the body. They don't raise insulin as much. They don't raise blood sugar as much. But when we look at some of these different bad carbohydrates, they lack nutrients, they're empty calories. In many cases, they have the fiber stripped away from them, so they just act completely different on the body, the blood sugar, the insulin. And so it's very good to make sure that you know the difference between them. And so when we look at good carbs, we're looking at sweet potato. You know, choosing sweet potato over white potato is a really good decision. The next is going to be butternut squash, black beans, blueberries, you know, really high nutrient dense, high antioxidant, low glycemic index fruits are really great. Blueberries, green apples, grapefruit. And then these are just some quick examples, okay? Now, to give you examples of, you know, bad things, is going to be your pasta, your white bread, you know, the crackers and cookies and snack bars. Once again, these don't offer you nutrients, but they offer you a lot of carbohydrates. And just because the nutrients are stripped away, the fibers are stripped away, what they're going to do is really just skyrocket those blood sugar levels and also your insulin levels. So we have to make sure that we're making better choices, because there's so many diets out there, as I mentioned, that just don't differentiate between good and bad carbs. They just tell you, you know, keep your carbs at this level, but they don't tell you that you need to make sure, along with that, that you're making good carbohydrate choices. Let's go ahead and talk about how much, okay? Now, when we look at the ketogenic diet, on average, you're going to want to be at 50 grams of carbohydrates or less, okay? And this is just following kind of a standard keto diet. Now, if you're someone who has insulin resistance, or you have, you know, diabetes, you have a health condition that you're looking to get under control, then you're going to want to even take that down further. You know, you go 25 grams or less, you're going to see a lot better results. And so when we look at carbs, once again, 50 grams or less on average, but 20 grams or less if you have some sort of health condition you're trying to overcome, and that's going to be very powerful. Now, though I love the ketogenic diet, I also love a low carb diet, and the reason for that is because it's more sustainable for many people. And you know, I work clinically with a lot of people, and I know that it is, you know, following the ketogenic diet is way too much for a lot of people. And I say that because, you know, people will tell me they followed the ketogenic diet, and I'll ask details, and I can, you know, find out very quickly that they followed a high fat diet that was not keto at all. They just added in a lot more fats. And then, you know, a lot of people, they will, you know, try it for 3 days and give up. And so here's the deal. When we look at all these different articles and videos on the internet, it's very quick to think that the ketogenic diet is something that everybody's easily doing and following. But what I can tell you is that though the ketogenic is very powerful, it's very hard for many people to follow. And so that's why I also love a good low-carb diet, because you're going to see great results with it as well. Now, on a low-carb diet, you're going to want to consume between 100 and 200 grams of carbohydrates, okay? Now, that also, I understand that's a big variation from 100 to 200, but it really depends on a lot of different factors. So let's say average is 150 grams on a low-carbohydrate diet, okay? Now, whether you're a small, petite person or you're a bigger person, that's going to make a difference. Whether you're an athlete or someone who doesn't exercise at all, makes a big difference. And so what you want to do is look at that and go, okay, well, if 150 grams is average, then where do I need to be? And I think that if you go ahead and play with that a little bit and you know, try 100 grams and then you try upwards of 200 grams, you're going to find out real quick where you need to be. And if you're consuming, you know, down towards the lower amount, you feel great and you're, you know, shedding fat and you're, you know, getting the results that you want to see, then stay there. But if you're actually able to go and consume 150 grams and feel really great and stay healthy and look healthy and feel healthy, then that's great as well. So anyway, the ketogenic diet is powerful. The low-carb diet is also very powerful and more sustainable for most people. I also wanted to mention to you that when, of course, you're following these diets, they're always eating high quality carbohydrates, never low quality carbohydrates. And what I'll do is I'll put a list of the different carbohydrates that I recommend, good, high quality, nutritious carbohydrates that I recommend. There'll be a link in the description below so we can email you that list of good carbs that you can eat. So other than that, be sure to put any questions you have in the comment section below and I'll get back to you. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel here and give this video a thumbs up. I'd greatly appreciate that. And then check out my other videos on the ketogenic diet and all the ways that you can improve your health. I'll see you in the next video.